Actually moving back onto schedule at an incredible pace. This is really quite wonderful. But I'm going to make one small change. We were hoping to be joined by another illustrious Swamiji who was unable to join us today. But I'm going to rearrange the schedule just a little bit. We are joined by Colonel Prabhat Bandaji here. And this is, I mentioned to you that we received support and encouragement from many corners of the globe. And Colonel Dean, he responded and said, I would like to come and be present and give your initiative a little bit of a boost from India. Colonel Dean is a member of the BJP's National Executive. And so our efforts here to present a unified Hindu scholarly board have been noticed far and wide. So I'm going to hand the microphone over to Colonel Dean, and thank you so much for joining us. We're very, very much grateful. Would you like to say?
Firstly, everyone might be thinking, what is a soldier who has done 25 years doing among sadhus? I'll be thankful for three things. The first thing, that learning about UK, how they ruled us, and imagining in films and forming an idea after 50 years of age, I landed up first time yesterday. That's my first happiness. Second is that I got a forum which is so much vibrant away from India, what we say Saat Samandar Paar. And third is the attire which I am wearing. I am from the Brigade of the Guards, and we have got the heritage from the Holstein Guards of the Buckingham Palace. So with this note, firstly, all honorable elders, brothers and sisters, I have been given 10 minutes, but I will finish within 5 to 6 minutes. Because when I was a kid, and when something was very moving in this space, we used to always bang the nearby chair and say, yeah, when will we finish? So I hope the elbows are not going left right. Anyway, I, Colonel Prabhat Panda, from the land of Kashmir to Kanyakumari, Vedas and Yogas, and of course, I am a Hindu nationalist. A BJP national assembly member, which Gautam ji has already told, a new turn is being brought in the soil of the nation. Yes. India, as we know, is Hindustan or Bharat, but in the one of the gathering in the minority cell, we have minority cell. I was called as a speaker, and what I told there in 1 minute, I will repeat. The minority cell, I told, why are you confusing Hindutva? Hindutva is Indutva, the great civilization which bred on the bank of river Indus. That's why I gave an example that a girl by any name, very far off from India, can go off without asking her parents with her friend's brother, but the same girl in India will refrain, that is Hindutva. I am from a Muslim dominated area. My Rahma will not go for second marriage. If he does, all elders, irrespective of caste, will thrash him. But he can go in other place outside India, and they will all join the Bharati. In India, it doesn't happen. That is Hindutva. And the response which I got was, sir, till now we thought it is Hindustan, but we never knew there is Hindustan also. So we are from Hindustan, and in that Hindu culture, we have the Hindu, which is more vast, encompassing everybody. As for me, serving as an army officer for 25 years in the Indian Army, let me bring out some true facts. The number one fact is that the religion dictates the patriotism. Here comes the difficulty. How are we balancing patriotism and nationalism in one letter. A soldier has to be patriotic. At the same time, he is also, like his citizen, has to balance his religious aspect. But let me give in this August gathering, in this historic hall, before 250 years, this mantra was given by my predecessor, the British Raj, British officers. They never interfered in the religious aspect of the we then soldiers, and it is being continued till now. As a Hindu-born officer commanding Sikh troops, I cover my head, I go to the Gurdwara. My brother officer, born in a Muslim family, in a hardcore Hindu battalion, he goes to the Dharamsthan. And my another brother officer, who is a Christian, and he is commanding in a 100% Muslim battalion, which we have very proudly, he goes and does the namaz. Every Sunday morning, 6 o'clock, we have to go, we do it, we attend, it is called the Dharamsthan parade. We don't do, punishment is there for the soldier next morning, 10 o'clock hotel room on Monday. So this is the way this land's officers had taught us. Draw his nationalism through his religion. Religion is being taken as a positive way, and this is how. For example, already given, as a person, what I mean to say is that first, one has to be a true Hindu, one has to be a true Christian, one has to be a true Buddhist, then he can be a true nationalist. Belgium brings nationalism. I am proud to be a Hindu nationalist. So also, you people who are here, you are proud Hindu British nationalist. And my sisters or brothers, anyone who is a British Christian, for me is a Christian British nationalist and a hardcore nationalist, it should be there. Religion acts as a booster, as I have told, and the national mission of a nation is always leads to positivity. A pious person who is faithful to his religion will always be faithful to his nation. A person who is not faithful to his religion will never be faithful to his country. This we have proved in 35 years I have seen this. Either he is court-martialed or he is thrown out of the regiment. A proud Christian in my country can become the chief of naval staff, can become the chief of air staff. He has the secrecy within himself. A Muslim born can occupy the highest chair, the President of India. The secrecy or even the security as the Chief of Defence Force, the three chiefs are under him. It is what I would say, religion leads to nationalism and not the other way. If it does, history has seen it is draconian. Whenever a dictator has poked his nose, he has not only burnt it, but he has burnt the nation. And that is what some of the fundamentalist nations are doing, where the chief administrator tries to indulge in the religious aspect, the nation's fabric gets disturbed. Hinduism teaches for peaceful coexistence of everybody. As told by my previous speakers on nature, on animal, and one point when somebody may be out of joke or something told that ant also. By the way, in my hometown, there is an ant temple. Uska naam hai Chinti Mandir. Agar ghar mein jyada chinti ho raha aapka, aap jaiye, wahan pe thoda sa sugar ya mithai kuch dal dijiye. Chinti gayab ho jate hain ghar mein. I don't know it happens or not, But it is to remind the human being in Hinduism that please care for the chinti also. Like the rat. And the chinti mandir is adjacent to the Isht Devi, Samleswari, the main deity of Sambalpur. So after performing your puja, please go to the ant and also push par chini mini dal do. The scriptures which we all know, the pujas which we all do. A lady starts her day worshipping a plant. Someone may say what it is, but it's purity, tulsi. She lights a lamp in the morning, in the evening. It is diya, godhuli lagi. Her children are taught by her, go and touch the feet of my parents, your father's parent. That is Hindutva, that is Charitra, that is Sanskar. A land where animal, nature, sun, moon, everything is concentrated, and in the end, I would say that some people even joke, like we have got the Sardar jokes, ki tusi to jada dhal aur talwar sara tuhanu bhagwan nu dinda fir. Many people joke with us ki aap to jitne bhi aapke weapon the aapne to maa bhagwati ko de diya aur khud aap wahan pe manjira mein jaane lage. Main bola karda gal nahi hai, Punjab mein aisa nahi hota na Bharat mein. Suno, she teaches us कि जब जब महिषासुर देश में जन्म होगा उसका वध करना है, और वध मंजीरा से नहीं होता, वध त्रिशूल से होता है. That is what she said. That is why in the end, the size of the painting which we have here, triple size we have in the College of War in Mau, in Central India, where we all go and rehash our knowledge in College of War. It was College of Combat. Atalji changed it to College of War. He don't want combat, make it war. We told sir, you have no real object. Then he told, I have started. You just make it war. You are coming here not to do combat, to fight war. There is the biggest photograph of Lord Krishna and Arjuna is there, where he is laying down the arms. So he is told that Bhagavad Gita is a fight. If you win, you will have the crown. If you lose, you will go to Vaikunth. Thank you. Then.
Thank you very much, Colonel Mandati. And as I say, thank you for taking the trouble to be with us and bringing some of the energy that is going around, tangibly going around in New Delhi and in India at the moment. Thank you so much.